Hello and welcome to another episode of my Working with Todoist series. My name is Carl Pullein and this week it's all about duplicates, and more precisely, duplicating projects and sections. And why would you want to do that? Well, that is what I'm going to show you this week. Now, before we go any further, I would just like to say, if you do get any value from this video, then please help me by clicking on that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, and you want to get all the latest tips, tricks, and news on using Todoist, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me take you into my demo account now, and I'm going to show you all about duplicating projects and sections. Okay, so here we are with my Email Mastery Course 2021 Update Task List. Now, I haven't organized this into sections. All I've done is just put out pretty much the, 17 or so tasks that I would need to do in order to get this course launched. Now, this is real. This is not actually my real account, but this is a real project that I'm working on. Now, the thing is, my Email Mastery course is not the only course that I will be updating this year. I have a number of other courses that I also plan to update. Now, the tasks associated with updating these courses are identical. I still have to create the outline. I still have to decide on the branding. I have to do the course description, edit the course description, schedule the 2 days for recording, etc., etc. All of this is the same for every course. The only thing that's going to change is things like, as you can see in here, I've got work on email mastery outline, and down here I've got email mastery outline. But these can be very, very easily changed, and I don't need to keep remembering it. Now, there's a couple of ways of doing this in Todoist. The first one, which is kind of like the traditional way, is we can actually create a template. And if you go to the three dots right up here on the right-hand side, you can click on that, and I can see down here, export as a template. When I click on that, I can export it as a file, which would give me a CSV file, so I can save that in a folder somewhere, or I can export it as a shareable URL, in which case what I would do is be given a URL, which I can copy and paste into it. But that's one way, and that's the traditional way we've always done with creating templates. But Todoist have been adding these little extras throughout the year so far, and one of them now is this function here. Now, I think it's been around for a while, but you can actually duplicate the project. So all you need to do in this case is click on that, duplicate the project, and you'll see down here in the left-hand corner, copy of Email Mastery Course 2021 update, and it's identical. All it's done is it's actually opened up my branding subtask here, which is great. That's one way of doing it. So I can do that. Now, what I would suggest, if you do decide to do this and create a copy of a project like this, what I would do is I'd create a new project, call it templates, like this, and add that. And then what I would do is I would actually just drag that down. See, I've got to grab the drag handles, drag that down and put it underneath the template. So now I actually have the template. What I can then do is I can go in here and edit the project, and I can do, I will just change this to online course project. There we go. And that's what I would create. I would just rename the project, which you can do. So I've called it Inline Project. Oh, there you go. You see, once again, I am sticking to my tradition of being unable to spell, or shall we say a typo. So there we go, online course update. So this is one way that I would do it. And I would just create from an existing project that as I'm working on. Now the beauty of this is, as you're working on a project, you are gonna be adding things. So one of the problems I find with the GTD model, which is plan out the project, plan out the tasks, you don't really know the tasks that you need to do in order to complete the project. You know what to start with, and you probably know the second and third task. But after that, it's just what needs to happen next. And that's why I find that actually creating a template is usually best done on a live project. Once you've completed the project, you will see all those tasks that you need to do and then it's done. So there you go. That's one way of doing it. So that's another way. However, I don't use projects in Todoist. As you probably know by now, I use the time sector system. So the time sector system is somewhat different. What I do here is go back up to my this week right here, and you'll see that I've got a floating project, and I've got 13 tasks in there, not the 17, but I've got 13 tasks in there. And actually I do, because there's this one here, which is the 4 additional tasks. So I've got my floating project, and I'll put a link to the floating project video I did a few weeks ago. And this is where it is. So if I'm going to be working on this particular course, and this is how I'm doing it in my real Todoist account, I actually create this as a floating project. So it's right here, and I can now work on the email mastery outline. Let's say I've done that, so that's checked off. I'm now currently working on the course branding. So I go into my sub projects here. I've decided on the color scheme. That's true. I've decided on the fonts. That's true. I've actually decided on the course image, but I haven't created the course banners yet. Now, if I click on that, one of the nice things is, well, about using subtasks is you don't lose the task. You've got them actually right there, so you can see what you've done. So you can now see what I'm doing on this particular course. So that one's being done. So as I'm going through my projects here, I can actually go through, I haven't done this, I haven't done that, I have scheduled that, I've got these to do, and all these will be done later. So when I'm going, when I've got a session of work that is ready for working on, so let's say this afternoon when I finish recording these courses, I'm going to spend some time on my email mastery course update, then this is what I will do. Now, for those of you who are thinking, oh, this is on this week, that's true. But what I'm going to do is, if I actually do this, I'm going to add today's date. Sorry, if I add today's date, because this looks a bit messy in writing this list, I'm going to add it into today. So now I've got my task. It's right there. When I click on that, I can get all my tasks that I'm working on, and I got it right there in front of me when I'm working on the project. So it's not as if it's going to be in a complete list of this week, because I don't really work out of this week folder. I work out of my filters. So today's focus work. So this just needs a flag. If I say this is my absolute must-do task today, so that's going to be coming up in my today's focused work right there. Click on the task and get on with the work. So then I've got my list of tasks that need to be done for my email mastery course right there. And you can do this with all sorts of things. For example, I was playing around with this and I created my weekly content creation course. So if you are actually using projects rather than the time sectors, then you can create what you need to do your, say, content that you create each week. So in this case, write first draft of blog post, blah, 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 blah. Now, all these, to be fair, are going to come up in, would be coming up in my daily list anyway. But you can just go up to the top here at the end of every week when you've done your content, you can actually create, in fact, actually you wouldn't do that. What you would do is you would duplicate the project like that. I get a copy of my weekly content. I would go in there. I would edit the project and hang on. I would edit the project. Let's go in there and click on the right one. Edit the project. And I would just remove weekly content creation. Let's give it a different name because it template. And then that would be put into my templates folder like this. So save that. And now I can just drag that into my templates folder, just drag it underneath there. And now I've got inside my templates, I've got the two template projects that I may or may not use in the future, but that's where you can put them. So there you go. That's just a few ways that you can do. Before I go, there is another thing that I should just point out. If we're going to the weekly content creation, one of the things that you can also do is sections. As you can see, when I click on here, the blog post, I've got the three dots for sections. You can actually duplicate sections as well, and you can then you've got those that you can actually use from within the project. So there's quite a few places that you can duplicate within Todoist. So there you go. That's just to give you an overview of the duplication options and a few ways that you may or may wish to or may not wish to use it. Thank you very much for watching this episode, and it just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Hello, thank you very much for watching my videos. Now I have something exciting to tell you about. Recently I have developed a brand new time management system. It's a system designed to manage your time in the 21st century.
The world has changed a lot over the last 20 years. In fact, it's actually changed a lot this year. And what we need now is a system, a time management system that is very easy to use, easy to maintain, so that you can spend more of your time doing the work. And that's what the time sector system is all about. It's going to change your whole belief system about the way a time management system should work, because this focuses on when you are going to do the task. And let's be honest, it doesn't matter how motivated, inspired, or how urgent something is. If you don't have time to do it, it is never going to get done. And that's what this system is built around, getting your work done, so you can spend more of your time doing the things that you want to do. I hope you join me in this course. The full details of the course are in the show notes below, so please join me, and thank you very much for watching this brief video.